Conversation started intensifying through the day yesterday, and then kind of heated up this morning. We got done just a few hours before the actual game time.
How hard a deal is this to pull the trigger on for you, after sort of your personal experience and what he's meant for the franchise?
Well, I think anytime you trade a guy as a face of your franchise, been here a long time, done a lot of good things for the organization on the ice and in the community, it's never an easy day. You know, we have a friendship on the side as well, which makes it even more difficult. But, you know, he was a real pro about it. And, unfortunately, it's the, kind of the crappy part of our business when stuff like this happens.
What can you tell us about the prospect you got from New York?
Cyril's, you know, he's about a 5'11", roughly 200-pound, more of a goal scorer than a playmaker for me. So I'll play center last year at the U18s in Switzerland. I played the wing this year in the World Juniors in Finland, and they won the gold medal. I think he's a good prospect. I think he's number one on the team in goal scoring in the men's league in Finland, and number two in points. So we think there's some good upside to him, and we're excited to have him as part of the group.
Well, he's kept your cards close to the vest during this process. At what point was it inevitable that this was the way you were going to go, to ask him to waive the no-trade clause?
Well, I think there's, you know, I think as you go through it, there's a respect. So certainly you want to keep everything as close as you can. I mean, he's got a wife and kids, and I think when you make these decisions, they're never easy. So you try and keep it as much as you can close to the vest. We've had, you know, multiple good discussions. You know, going back to last summer as we went through this process, and it became more evident as we get closer to the deadline. Unfortunately, we lost the games leading up to you know, the end of last week with the Toronto game at home against Boston, which, you know, wouldn't bet against this group, but it makes it a lot tougher for us to make the playoffs.
Was the last few games, did that kind of hasten your decision, or was this a plan on the line?
No, I think you're kind of sitting there looking where you're at, and this group has played some really good hockey from you know, December to this point, and they're working hard. You never want to have to do this, but when you look at the big picture, if you know, we couldn't get comfortable on a contract term, then you can't lose an asset like that for nothing. You know, it's too important to the franchise moving forward. So, thankful that Eric was willing to waive the no move. I mean, he didn't have to do that. He did that in order to allow us to do this, and you know, we feel it gives us some building blocks to continue to move toward the direction we want to go.
Were the Rangers the only team you approached him about, or were there other opportunities that you need to seek his permission?
I've had conversation with different teams, but as far as which teams I had permission to do and stuff and how many, I'd like to keep that more or less between us at this point. I mean, like I said, he didn't have to give me any permission anyway. There's no one to do that, so I appreciate that.
You know, you're not done. Maybe you have another till 3 o'clock tomorrow. Are you still looking to do more?
Yeah, it's something we'll have to wait and see what happens between now and then.
Jordan Staal remains behind, and he kind of wears his heart on his sleeve. I mean, both of them do, how much they wanted to play with each other. So are you concerned at all about what that may mean to his adjustment period?
Yeah, there's no question. It'd be tough on Jordan. It'd be tough on Cam Moore. They've been teammates together for a long time. So tough on those guys in the room. I mean, he was their captain, and you know, a lot of these young guys came in. They looked up to him over the years, and now he's no longer there. So there's certainly going to be an adjustment period. But, you know, we feel we've got a lot of good character guys in that locker room, a lot of good young pieces, and it's a chance for them to take another step forward.
And you leave the captaincy vacant for the rest of the season. Is that the plan?
Yeah, I haven't talked to Bill, but that would be my assumption. We would leave it.
That said, the players, you could hear them warming up and et cetera, but at what point did they find out, or did they find it out at all while they're preparing?
They would have found out prior to the game, prior to going out for warm-ups. You know, I came down and talked to Eric because they obviously didn't sign the waiver for the no moves. That's when they would have found out, I'm sure, at that point, because we would have told them.
What did this say? Did it all come down like 2 o'clock just before the game? Well, he was already here, right?
Yeah, he was here. I've been working on it most of the day, and then it sort of came to the head and went down and talked to him. I don't know the exact time, but roughly in that 1:32 o'clock window, something like that.
Cyril really had some injuries a couple of years ago. You feel good that he's not, quote, injury prone, but got a good future?
No, he's having a good year, and seen the nice in a couple of those tournaments. I really like the player. He's extremely competitive. Hopefully you didn't jinx him by asking that question.
Is this somebody you saw at the juniors when you went over to watch Aho?
Yeah, I saw him in Switzerland last year at the under-18s. Sebastian came over just for the championship game because his team was winning the title in Finland. He flew in for the last, the gold medal game, but Sorella was there. And then in the World Juniors this year, he played predominantly on the line with Ryan Pinnett and Captain. So, yeah, I've got him. But, you know, we have European scouts and amateur scouts who spent a lot more time with this guy, and they feel more comfortable with the prospect.
Well, do you think the decline in production the last 3 years for Eric this year, maybe does some of that amount to playing under the circumstances he's played under to this year, or maybe how much did that weigh into it? Because he dropped from 61 to 54 to the season he's having now. I know that's difficult.
Well, I don't think it's ever easy to be in the situation he was in. You know, you're playing out the last year of your contract. You have a lot of uncertainty whether you're going to be here or not. You know, I think in his heart he would like to be here. He mentioned numerous times he liked the direction we're going in. The young pieces coming, and he was excited about that. So I think it's never easy when you have this to deal with while you're trying to play the game. So certainly I'm sure that has some effect on him. You know, I think this change will be a good opportunity for him. You go to New York, it's a good team. You get to play with some players that have had a lot of success, and I think he can just play the game. He doesn't have to bear the burden of wearing the C and being the leader and you know, a lot of other things. So, you know, I think he can hopefully relax, have some fun, and be successful in New York.
Ron, if he's a free agent on July 1st, if Eric is, I think you would have interest in talking with him.
Trying to trick me, I can't comment on other teams' players now. He's considered another team's player, so I can't make any comment on that. I can't talk about other teams' players.
But you also mentioned the term, I guess. You could get comfortable on the term. Is that term and money, or
We talk more in generalities than specifics, but, you know, I think for me it was more, you know, at the stage he was at his career and the stage we are as a franchise and what we're trying to build. I think it was difficult for us to get comfortable with a longer term. That is really what it came down to. And, you know, I think in his shoes, I don't think he was asking for the world. I think he, you know, his kind of parameters were fair, and I don't think, you know, he'll probably have a hard time getting it on July 1 from somebody, but it just didn't fit for us with where we are now and where we're going.
Okay.